welcome. In this video, we will be going over how to record a harvest event on Croptracker's desktop platform. Click the Growing drop-down menu and select Record Harvest. You can also click on the blue New Harvest button at the top of the dashboard list. The first step prompts you to fill in the harvest event details. Enter an event title and select the event status. The event status can be used to plan activities in advance and then confirm when they have been completed. Optionally, select a category. This field will be populated by information already entered into Croptracker and can be used to group your events using your own custom categories. For more information on how to add categories or what they are used for, check out the knowledge base links in the description. Enter the harvest start date and the harvest end date. These dates can be edited as needed later if the harvest is delayed or takes more time than expected. The following optional fields can be filled in to add more detail to your reports. Fill in the condition of crop. This list is filled from past information you've entered here as well. You can select from the list or type directly into this field to enter a new condition. Select whether you're harvesting by machine or by hand under Harvest Method, and select the management level. Enter the weather information as needed. This information is used on some GAP reports. When you are done, hit the blue Next button at the bottom of the page. The next section, Where, will show you a map of your farm and a list of your crops by block. Select the block or blocks you'll be harvesting from using the map or the list. You can plan a harvest event for as many blocks at a time as you need. Hit Next when you are done. The third step, Tracking Codes, allows you to assign tags to your harvest for traceability and inventory purposes. Croptracker will generate unique codes using the block name and the date. To use the Croptracker codes, click on the blue Tag button. To input your own codes, simply type into the field. This step will also let you know if the pre-harvest and re-entry intervals for these blocks have passed. If they have not passed, there will be a red warning. When you have finished, hit the blue Next button at the bottom of the page. The fourth step, Confirm, will show the calculated harvest area based on the blocks selected. Optionally, select the packing materials you'll be using. You can select from the list or type what you're using. This will not link to your packing material inventory. To learn more about how to track packing inventory and materials, check out the video links in the description. To save your harvest event and add your harvest inputs later, or to add harvest inputs from your mobile device, hit Save and you'll be returned to the dashboard. To move straight to recording your harvest inputs on the desktop, hit the blue Save and Continue to Inputs button. This will take you to the Inputs screen. From here, you'll see a list of the blocks you selected in your event. Pick the block that you're adding your inputs from and click on the Add Input button. This will open up a window to record your inputs. Enter the volume amount harvested and select the volume unit or harvest container from the drop-down menu. Select the volume unit. The volume unit is a mandatory field that refers to the container you're harvesting into, but the list includes a variety of generic units like bins, picking baskets, and totes that can be selected instead if you don't need to track the specific volume. You can add the weight per unit and the system will calculate the total weight of the harvest for you. Or, if you know the total weight of your harvest and prefer not to track by the harvested unit, you can just enter the total weight and select the weight unit from the dropdown. The weight unit for the total will be populated with the same unit you select next to the unit weight box. If you are separating your harvest into classes, you can select a harvest class here. For more information about adding harvest classes, check out the links in the description. If you have the punch clock module and have employees punched into the selected block, you can track their production rates in this harvest event by selecting them here. If you are paying piece rate, select one from the drop-down menu to start tracking pieces. Note that your piece rate unit must match either the volume or weight unit you selected above to properly calculate on reports. For more information on how to set employees and piece rates up, check out our videos on punch clock and employee setup. Next, you can add any notes as needed. If you're printing harvest labels, select the Format and Print option. Many growers print tags from the desktop ahead of harvest to be applied in the field as produce is packed. If you have the Storage module, you can optionally assign your harvest to a storage location from this window as well. When you are finished, you can select Save and Print Tag or Save. Your harvested units will now appear on the list. Repeat this step to add as many inputs as you need for every block you're harvesting from. When finished, press the blue Done button and your harvest will now appear on the dashboard. If you need to add more inputs or edit the event later, simply click the blue drop-down arrow next to View and select Edit or Edit Inputs. From here, you can also move your harvest straight to a storage, packing, or shipping event. This concludes our demonstration on adding a harvest event from the desktop. For more information, check out our other videos and visit our website at www.croptracker.com. And as always, thanks for watching!